When the lab door opens, hope and anticipation are the invisible partners that play a role in creating clinical trials. The lab is the proving ground, where researchers work tirelessly, focusing on discovery that will lead to new studies, and from those studies, the ultimate achievement.
My goal is to get something I've developed into standard of care for pancreatic cancer patients. That's the ultimate goal. I mean, I will feel like I have contributed to patients and to science. That would just make me so happy.
The work continues, and there are good results.
It used to be we'd have to say to patients, you try this new therapy that I have in my lab. I don't know what it's going to do. But now I can actually say to patients or my colleagues who are offering them the clinical trials can say to them, you know, we're seeing responses.
But not all studies are successful.
We probably learn more from the failure of a trial, especially now that patients are willing to give us biopsies because we can see in a patient whether the treatment is working. And if it didn't work, what happened in that tumor? What kind of signals were turned on that we may need to also alter to make it work better? The more we can understand before we go to the patient, the better success we have.
Leslie!
Hey there, how are
you? You ready?
I am.
Can I have your name or your card first?
Our patients are partners in this, and we're asking them to give up a lot, to give up their time, to take on therapies we don't know everything about, so they have to help us in figuring out what the therapy is doing to them, and they have to undergo biopsies. And by getting biopsies both before treatment and after treatment, and most of our patients are very happy to do that now, and it's a big deal, because they can have side effects from those biopsies. But we take that back to the lab, and we're able to better understand how the treatment worked. And that has changed everything. We can't tell the patient what to do. We have to be, as physicians, educate them and help them to make a decision that's going to be right for them. Sometimes you have to tweak a treatment to make it work better for different people. We learn a lot of different things when you're able to test agents at different centers, because different centers may attract different types of patients, different age groups, different sex, different minorities, and drugs do work differently in different groups. When you have a larger study at different centers, you can have more patient information to learn from the studies.
And that's where the hope and anticipation come into play. Patients can now anticipate a future.
I tell them what's out there, and I tell them, you know, try this, and when you're done with that, guess what? We have at least three or four more things for you to try. And the relief that they feel that nobody's giving up on them anymore.
These aren't just words of hope for patients. They are powerful partners in the philosophy of clinical trials.
And I truly do believe that people with hope do better. And we do know that people on clinical trials do better. We know that people on clinical trials are, they're followed more, they have a hope, they have a better feeling, well-being about themselves. And so I do believe that clinical trials have a lot of positives for patients beyond even testing a new therapy that may benefit them.